Everyone, welcome back to Fire Emblem Ogo, and this is another episode of Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. So, I will now fly to the Lumpy Pumpkin. I mean, in the night, I guess, where we have to look for our monster. That golden look says you might take an old man's rambling serious son. Even the skull of monster? You can even call it a monster, it's a demon, I tell you. But no one can say for sure because no one's seen it and lived to tell the tale. Huh? Well? You wanna know how I'm coming to live nobody has seen it or not? Is that it? Yeah. Yeah, well. Sorry, guys. Really thirsty. And in this game, unlike as in others, I can't be like, okay, yeah, well, I will take a drink while they talk. Yeah, well, I saw it, but I was able to escape by the seat of my pants. I was saved by my cat like reflexes, I tell ya. Any regular person wouldn't have lived long enough to scream. Anyway, I say the thing, I tell ya. I saw the thing, I tell ya. Great big tree, the cemetery. I walked by the tree in the middle of the night and I saw it hit the gravestone nearest the tree and the gravestone lit up. The gravestone nearest to the tree. I pushed the gravestone and the door to the storage shed opened up all by itself. The monster went into the shed and then it closed the door behind itself, which was unexpectedly polite for a demon. It was the most terrifying thing these old eyes have ever seen. If you're smart, you'll stay clear of the cemetery in the middle of the night. Oh, you're just in time for another job, that is. Next job is to help pick the pumpkins. Don't want to hear anyone ever complain. Okay? Should be an easy one for you. Luna spends her afternoons picking pumpkins in the patch out the back. Carry those to the storage shed. Can I give you the details? Oh, but you can only work in the patch during the day. You'll have them under the night sky. Okay. Well, let's do some. Next job has been decided. Looks like we'll be helping with the pumpkin harvest. What relief. Do you have any idea where these pumpkins are? I think this is going to be a piece of pumpkin cake, do you? Let's take this interesting. How about you carry 5 pumpkins at once? You better take it slow, you'll risk dropping them. Just get out there and haul those pumpkins. I guess I have to try it now, right? Okay then, I'll show you where you need to carry the pumpkins to. I guess. See the storage set up ahead? Carry the pumpkins there. Quick to carry several pumpkins wants us to walk slowly. To start to lean right, move right. Left, move left. Time and keep your balance. If pennings start to rush, well, you're going to drop them, so. Look! Right, left. You drop them, you can't be careless like that. Okay, it's to walk slowly. Start to lean right, move right. If you start to lean left, move left. Okay, again. Well, how slow am I supposed to be? Okay, not that slow. Once again. Wait, maybe if I... Okay, it feels strangely close to what you had to do with the... It feels kind of a bit like the... How to balance on the stone... last dungeon. Press the wrong button there. Ah, that was so close. I can do this. Must have been like a step away from it. Yes, it means you're done carrying her things. Thank you very much. Just wanna see if there's another thing to do. Oh, don't just sit here. Have you got something to do right about now? Impressive, you're done harvesting all those pumpkins. But don't celebrate yet, you still have your way super prepared. Is it? No time to think about Testament? Okay. So, midnight, graveyard. Hitting the graveyard that's closest to. Tree. just need a bed to sleep until next. Morning? But that you can sleep in all the beds. Ah. To some latent mischief, huh? Better watch yourself, or a remnant will take you bite off your backside. Most of us don't get out of the dark for a reason, you know?
Hey!
I thought I... Talk to the bob of mine for me? Except him while starting to repair the recipe. Okay, can I...
Hey!
Okay, no I can't. I have absolutely no clue where I'm going to, yeah? Thank God I can open it. I was like, I have nothing to light those. And delete it. What's wrong? Why do you look so scared? Did something happen to you? Stop, please, I beg of you, don't hurt me. Oh goodness, I know how bad this must look to you right now, but I assure you, I mean no harm. You're just playing the scream as loud as you can game. Isn't it a fun game? Oh. Perhaps an explanation. My name is Batro? Batro? I'm Batro. Batro. And I'm the master who resides here in this humble dwelling below Skyloft. But please allow me to correct one popular misconception. While I'm certainly a monster, I wouldn't dream of terrorizing the people of this town. You see, this adorable little girl is the only one who didn't let loose a blood-curdling scream at the sight of me. Since she began to visit me here, I felt positively jubilant. You see, my heart's only wish is to become friends with lovely people, Skylar. But as you can surely imagine, it has proven quite difficult to break the ice when they're struck with paralyzing fear at the inside of me. I assure you, nothing would fill my heart with joy more than to be friends with the fine people of this town. But as soon as I try to approach any of them, and extend my claw in friendship, the run and scream is to them. You've seen a walking nightmare? Yeah, because they think you want to kill them. Oh right, Slimmy, I've gotten ahead of myself. See, there's an old tale about my minstrel's king that goes as follows. Seems that when humans make other humans happy, the happy human produces a substance known as a gratitude crystal. Well, these crystals are quite amazing. Just looking at them and knowing there was such credit in the world could turn me from a monster into a human. Oh goodness, nothing would delight me more than to become a human. From the moment I laid my grip in the demonic eyes on you, I could tell you had a chance on getting a result. Won't you please get accredited crystals and show them to me? Okay. Really? You will help me? I've heard that you can obtain pure credit by helping people solve their troubles. They could also be merely lying about you in Scallop or elsewhere among the clouds, anywhere you find people. I'm sure someone with a pure heart as pure and genuine as yours will be able to see them. Please, solve some troubles and get me all the credited crystals you can find. Any help you can provide will be dearly appreciated. I promise, assistant, not going without. And you should be back home safe and sound by tomorrow morning. Give your parents my warmest regards when you see. Oh, and good luck getting you. But did your crystals are equipped to start? Please bring me 5 if you can. That would be suspended. With your great kindness for someone, you may even find several at once.
Hi!
It's not a bit of any. He saved me one time when I almost fell over the edge. It has me come here and scream as loud as I want. Anyway, he said it was dangerous to go out alone at night, so I'll just hang out here for a while. Not taking it. Let my mom not come home in the morning. Wait, can I come down or do I have to go there? Little Puggy went into his little cave. My wife and I both have our own tables in our working room. Mixed room, different stuff room. And I did put the chair from her table where so that the pug can go under the table and have his little cave there. What? Are you serious? You found Kukiel? But you tell you, nobody has got a time of hair on her head. And Kukiel? Well, I guess it's good to hear this, at least with a friendly and responsible adult, but just can't wait to see her. Sleep until morning. Okay, safely back at home, and it's all because of you. I don't know how to express my gratitude. I can finally smell love again. Thank you ever so much. I credited Crystal. It was fine. This was all from his gratitude in crystallized form. It must have taken a lot of gratitude to produce this bunch of 5 crystals. Helping people feels good. Well, see, let's go to Batteries? But Petro. Oh, it's you, Link. Uncle Pets. Patsy's told me wants to see all the gratitude crackles he can. They're going to do that. The what? Gratitude crackles? That sounds a bit strange. I wanna see if I can enter the lair in daytime too. Ah, I can now. Ah, just hold B. Might be the better way. Oh, you've gathered quite a lot of gratitude, haven't you? How magnificent. Petro, Uncle Bats. Please take this as a token of this demon's deepest appreciation. You got the wallet. was it is to up to 500 rupees in it. That's awesome. You need more credit crystals to become a human. Please, won't you approve of what you need?
What?
But that's really great. So, I can now store up to. And it's not. No! That's really nice. Okay, I guess it should be enough time to get the. To get the tablet in and see where we're going in the next episode. Gratitude crystals. Interesting. What I wanted to say before is that it's also typical for the Zelda games to be like, okay, there's a pre-part, simpler part if you want, where you get accustomed to the game, that's usually 3 parts long. So it's fitting with this Zelda tradition. Usually after the third one there is like a fourth to get to somewhere where you then can another time, another dimension, whatever. I'm already excited to see what it will be in this one. I've confirmed the location of a third opening, the cloud barrier in the sky to the southwest. So you to reach a new area on the surface, I should suggest going there as soon as you are suitable prepared. Well, that was anywhere cool. Are you too excited to find out where we're going to? I really hope so. But that will be one for the next one. Bye bye.